to show you some platysma bands that I treated here. This is a very slender guy, and you can see the muscle band that he has here. Now, this muscle goes from here all the way back. It runs from the jawline all the way down to the neck, and he works out a lot, so he's very thin, and the last thing he should have is liposuction in this area, but he does need to have jowls removed and things like this. So you can see he has a lot of lax tissue here. He's an executive, and it's really, he said, it's important that I not be the subject in the room, that people don't think about, oh, you're getting old, it looks like you should retire. And he also works out. He had already ripped out both shoulders because he works out so much. So think what you have to do for platysma muscles like his. So what I did is I sutured them together in the middle with all these interrupted sutures, and then another layer on top of that, and I divided the platysma muscle. And the reason I wanted to show him is because his platysma muscle was the thickest one I've ever seen. Now, you sent me an actress earlier this year from LA who had very prominent platysma bands, but hers were very thin because they had been Botoxed, and she doesn't have a workout schedule like this gentleman. So, right. So on to what Dr. Hidalgo says, the platysma bands are very different in each person, so they have to be treated differently. So you can see this is what he was like before, and this is what he was like afterwards. Now, you posted somebody the other day that was 2 days post-operative, a guy,
yes.
And this person is 2 years and 4 months, which
amazing.
When I have my facelift, I want to look at 2-year follow-ups because I want my neck to look like this. I want to have a jawline that is like this. I want to have a smooth neck with no more platysma bands. I did want to show the neck contour before versus the neck contour now. So this is what I'm looking for, is a smooth neck that doesn't look overdone, doesn't look overpulled or stretched. And he said, I can't go back and have anybody know that I had a facelift. So look at his incisions. Let's see
those incisions. You can't
right,
even find them.
Exactly. So let's go really close here. And looking around here, and as the one, I was a little concerned about the one that you showed the other day, because what we have here is something that is completely hidden. He was really worried about behind his ear. So we make our incisions, as you know, up high. So it's in the hairline. So you can't see any incision here, even for both men and women that wear their hair short. So I thought he would be a good example for you as somebody that we really have to be very assertive with their platysma band. So postoperatively, he can wear
Look
his white shirt and not have any skin hanging down on his neck.